Hello everyone, Jane Gallina here, also known as Airplane Jane with your Daily Five. If you all are new to following me, this is pretty much everywhere you can follow me. I am easily accessible on Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, LinkedIn, Facebook, my website, cjanetrade.com, and also you guys can always email me at jane@cjanetrade.com. Let's go ahead and get into the charts for today. So first off, obviously everyone is always using the SPY as a benchmark or the S&P 500 for performance. And right now we did see a downward turn in September, which is not unusual when we talk about the seasonality. Typically we do see tend to see a contraction in the market for the month of September. However, are we going to continue down from here? I absolutely love these candlesticks on stock charts, ACP charts, where they're going to show you the volume. And you can see that we had really big selling volume in the beginning of September, the 3rd and the 4th. Why do I say selling volume? Because the price action right now is below those two candlesticks. We had a nice downward turn, came down, tested the 321 area, and slowly but surely we're creeping back up. We do have a gap to fill to the downside, roughly 331 back down to 329.50. And we are at a crucial area. Are we going to end up red on the day today? Today is the end of the quarter. There could be a lot of rebalancing. There might be some repositioning that's going to happen. And if we can close below 333.50, feeling like we might continue on with this downward trend with the seasonality. Now, when we're also looking at the SPY daily chart here, and we move forward and look at seasonality, this is from Equity Clock. This dark blue line does have the seasonality, and sure enough, shows a downward turn. The pink is normal average over, 50 years worth of data here. So the blue line, we come down end of September, bounce up right into October, and then we have another downward turn almost for the first week and a half of the month of October. Then we go sideways a little bit and upwards right into the election. So looking at this to see, is this pattern from the past 59 years going to hold true? End of today, we are ending up. Not a surprise, we have that right here on the end of September. When we also look at the two major stocks in both the SPY and the Qs, which are Apple and Microsoft, they're also somewhat in that downward trend. It's not a surprise that these charts tend to look the same because they are big influencers in both the NASDAQ and the SPY. So when we're looking at it, again, big selling volume, September 3rd and 4th, a little bit bigger volume the first day that we were below the 50 simple moving average, that is the white line right here, and two big areas that I would look for to see if we're going to have that continuation to the upside or continuation to the downside is, are we going to break above the consolidation roughly with a 119 resistance? We have had lower volume lately on these volume candlesticks. Or are we going to break down and go below 105? Our stochastics, we are not in that overbought area as of yet. I do not use this as an indication to get into it. But for the past 2 weeks, we have seen fairly heavy dark pool volume. And so looking to see which direction are they really going to take it? Are they going to take it up or are they going to take it down? Right now, it's in an indecision area. And we might see a further pullback. We are still below major volume from the 9th and the 5th right here, 4th, 5th right here, where these were two very heavy dark pool days. If we can break above those, yes, going back up. If we stay below, sayonara, I think we'll be heading back down with the market, much like that seasonality SPY chart. When we look at Microsoft as well, Microsoft dropped below. There's the big news, hey, they're gonna partner with TikTok. Oh, no, they're not. Big selling action came down to roughly 196, bounced from there, still holding below the 50 simple moving average on the daily and looking to see if we're able to close above 208.20, this 21 EMA right here. That is one that I do tend to use as a trend change. So we came up, we had a doji day right around the 50 simple moving average below it, and we are testing it now. So are we going to be able to continue to the upside or break down further? Moving forward, when we look at the Qs, very similar chart to Apple, not a surprise, right? And something else with Apple and Tesla, they both had a big run up into the splits and then they pulled back. There was selling volume after that. Found a new support and slowly but surely, little bit of volume coming into them, drawing them up. So it's not a surprise that we see that the Qs looks almost exactly the same as the Apple chart. Now we are above that 21 EMA here. However, if we see that we are able to close above 281, even 282.50, I would put as that resistance. We have a little gap to fill here on the Qs if we break above 280. And if we are not able to, I would watch out for potential selling up here around that 280 whole dollar mark. When we look at Tesla, Tesla again ramped up into the split, which happened August 30th. And then there was selling power, came down to the 50 simple moving average. And now we are in a wedge. So it came down, bounced upper end of the wedge, heading back down. Up, we're at the upper bounds right now. And are we going to break out or is this going to be a strong resistance barrier? And we're going to come back down to that 50 simple moving average, roughly at 372.80. When we look at our seasonality for Tesla, this is only 9 years of data. So please keep that in mind. But we do see that there is a great run from the third week of January all the way up until typically the third week of September. Then it starts to have a bit of a downturn. When we look at that chart, we started coming down beginning of September due to that split. However, this is somewhat holding true. We bounced up, came down, bounced up, came down, bounced up, ending up right here the end of September. And are we going to have that downward turn until the third week of November? That is from a 60% to a 40%. So if we're hanging out up here roughly at 430, and we take off, and that's 60% gains, and we take off 20, we might be looking at roughly 300 mark for a potential target for the third week of November. Now, a lot of this data, I also combine the dark pools, which is where those big whales of the market do trade. And if you are interested in learning more about the dark pools, please feel free to join us over at the training pit at thedarkpools.com. And again, if you have any questions, you guys are always able to reach out to me at jane@cjanetrade.com. Thanks for watching your Daily Five.
Hey, Grayson Rose here with StockCharts. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, consider giving it a like down below, maybe leave us a comment. And if you're new to the channel, you can subscribe at the link up above. We're gonna bring you daily content from an incredible collection of technical analysts and financial experts.